Are pileup regions causing you problems in your genetic genealogy? Do you even know what a pileup region is? Well, let's try to answer that question for you today. Howdy, welcome to Family History Fanatics, where we love helping you climb your family tree and have fun along the way. If you're new to genetic genealogy, chances are you have tons of questions. Be sure to check out the link in the description below for our free guide to the 5 most common DNA questions that we have answers to. Pileup regions can be the bane of genetic genealogy research, and for a couple of reasons. Let's go over why they are such a problem and what they even are. Well, the first problem of why they're a problem is that there's really no official definition. If you look on the ISOG website, you can find a pseudo definition of there are some regions of the genome that are prone to excess IBD sharing. These regions are colloquially known as pileup regions. Colloquially. I've highlighted that word because it basically means that, hey, that's what we call them, but we don't necessarily have a good definition of them. So let's take a look at what these could be. Now, Debbie Cruz-Kinnett has a blog where she actually defines 3 different types of pileup regions. Now, the first one is lack of phasing. And what phasing is when we take your pair of chromosomes, each one, and we separate it out into a mother and a father. Now, if we don't separate it out, then it's entirely possible that a match doesn't actually match you all the way across. For instance, you may have a 7 centimorgan match, but really, if you had separated out your chromosomes, it would show that, no, there's a 3 centimorgan match on your mother's side and a 4 centimorgan match on your father's side that happen to butt up next to each other in that area. Or it might disappear completely because that match was actually just zigzagging between the 2 chromosomes. And so it wasn't even a match that could be measured at all once you phase those chromosomes. Now, you need to have your parents' DNA in order to phase the chromosomes. But if you have your parents' DNA, probably most of the time you're actually looking at the matches for your parents rather than yourself. Some of the DNA testing companies use some algorithms to attempt to properly phase those chromosomes, but they're not perfect because, again, you don't have that parental chromosome to actually verify that you have phased it correctly. So that's the first type that Debbie talks about. Now, the second type is pileup regions from SNP poor regions. Now, if you remember, SNPs are what is actually tested. They're a single nucleotide polymorphism, basically a point along your DNA where it could be one of 2 different letters. It's the places where our DNA is different or potentially different with other people. Now, SNPs are not equally distributed across our chromosomes. And in gedmatch, you can actually see this with the tier 1 Q matching tool. When you look at your chromosomes, it will show you the SNP density all along that. So for instance, these 2 red circled regions are actually regions of very low SNP density compared to some of the regions around them. Because of that low density of SNPs, it's very possible to match a lot of people in those regions, and hence you start to have a pileup. Now, the third type of pileup region that Debbie talks about is excess IBD, which goes back to what the ISOG definition was. IBD means identical by descent. In other words, we received the DNA from the same ancestors or that same ancestral population because it was pretty much ubiquitous. Now, there's several theories of why this could happen. Probably the most prevalent one is that these excess regions of IBD have a evolutionary advantage. In other words, there's a gene or something on there that gave the people that had that such an advantage that they had more offspring and hence passed on that section of DNA to more and more of the human population. And there's a couple of places on the human genome that we're pretty sure this is the case. One area of excess IBD can actually be found on chromosome number 15. This is a known one that affects lots and lots of people. What I've shown here is my chromosome 15, and this is just from the, I think, first 1,000 matches or 500 matches of all of my matches. Each line represents a different match to me. what we can see here is in this first part of chromosome number 15, basically the 20 to 30 million range, there are a lot of people that match me. But not only are there a lot of people that match me, if we look over here, it's all rather small. In many cases, less than 10 centimorgans. Now, how would that compare to, say, another segment that I match? Well, we can just look a little bit farther along chromosome number 15 over here. And this is actually right next to it. This is 30 million to 60 million or so. And we can see that I match several different people, but those matches are varying sizes. So we have some short ones, we have some longer ones, we have some in between, but all along this length is a little bit different. And that is what a normal matching segment is going to look like, is you're probably not going to have everybody matching that same small segment like we saw. And that's why we say that, hey, this one over here is a likely pileup region, because not only do we have a ton of people, again, this is just from the first 500 matches, and you know, almost 10% of the people of that match me in this place. If I looked at all 30,000 matches, it would likely be a couple of thousand people that matched in this one little spot. So it's a huge number of people, but it's also almost always a very small segment. Whereas we can see in these other matching regions, it's much larger segments that I match some people, and it's not everybody that I match, just this tiny small segment. So that is a likely pile up region. Now, like I mentioned, there are some known pile up regions, and you can just search on the internet for those, but the ones that you have may be different. You may not have these known pileup regions. You may have some other regions in your DNA that are pileup regions. Different populations have different known pileup regions. Again, I mentioned that this excess IBD may have something to do with an evolutionary advantage to that section of DNA, and so it's been perpetuated through a population. But we've had lots of population over tens of thousands of years that have had a chance to develop these. And so you're not always going to see the same pileup regions as your neighbor. Now, within your family, you probably have a lot of the same pileup regions. But just because you have those doesn't mean that everybody else doesn't have those. And so one of the things that people ask is, well, is there a list of, you know, pileup regions? And there really can't be a list of pileup regions. If you have a population big enough and you look at, you know, different areas where there's a large number of people that share that segment, there's also a lot of people that don't share that, but they have some that share another segment. And so these pileup regions really can happen all along each one of our chromosomes. There's no definitive list for that. And that's another reason why they are a bane to genealogy. It gives us matches that, while we may be related, we're not going to be related in a genealogical time frame. These segments have been passed down for hundreds and thousands of years in many cases because they're ubiquitous for that population. Now, if you would like to learn how to use the gedmatch one-to-one matching tool, you can click on this video up here. But if you'd want to learn something else about DNA, then why don't you try this video down below? See, I had like five or six mess-ups before. So now I'm going to have to do the same five or six mess ups.